In this video, you will learn how to set up and prepare all tools that you need in order to develop Vue applications. And we will use Vue CLI in order to generate these applications. Hi, I am Alexander Koherkin from Monster Lessons Academy, where I am teaching you how to become a developer or improve your skills of being a developer in learning by doing way. And if you are new here, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and I will link everything that I am mentioning in the description box below. So let's jump right into it. So here I am in the official page vuejs.org, and here is the link getting started. If we will scroll a little bit, there is a huge green button installation. It is possible to install Vue in different ways, for example just with the script from CDN, and this is really good for learning or testing purposes. But of course we don't want this approach in real projects. This is why we need something else. Of course we can just install it as npm package, but we are interested in CLI tool. What is CLI tool? This is a special command line tool which helps us to generate Vue project or Vue component and actually make some Vue stuff. And this is actually really nice because out of the box we will get a project which will be generated by Vue CLI, there will be a web server inside, and we will get a reloading of our web server on every page changes. So this is how we want to proceed. So we need to jump into the official CLI, and this is GitHub repository, and on the bottom we have a link to documentation. Here again we are jumping to getting started, and here on the left creating a project. So this is exactly what we will use, but here is a warning, and this is super important. So if you are on Windows, you need to use some nice terminal, for example git bash as it is recommended here, or cmd. Both these terminals are working nice with TTU. What is TTU? This is when you have interactive prompts. Because when we will generate our Vue project, you will get some questions, and we need to answer them correctly. If you don't have your terminal that work with interactive prompts, then Vue will just generate some default config, and we don't need that. This is why it's not possible to use, for example, default window terminal, and you need, for example, to install either git bash or cmd. If you are on Linux or Mac, you don't have this problem. Normally any terminal there will work out of the box. Also, it is important that you have on your machine installed Node. And to check if you have it or not, you can just in console write node minus version, and you need to get a version bigger than 10. Then everything will be fine and you can use Vue and Vue CLI. If you don't have Node on your machine, you can simply jump in nodejs.org and here download your Node version. I really recommend to use LTS version and not current, because it's normally more stable and you get less problems with it. After Node installation, we need to jump in installation section in Vue CLI, and as you can see here, this is exactly what I said, that version of the Node 10 plus is recommended. Now we need to install Vue CLI on your machine. You can either do it with npm or with yarn, it doesn't matter, you just need to copy this command in your terminal and hit enter. I won't do that because I already installed Vue CLI on my machine. This is why when I am writing Vue minus minus version, I am getting Vue CLI 4.5.6. And actually after installation, you simply need to check if you can do this with minus minus version. This means that you successfully installed Vue CLI on your machine and now you can generate a project. So how we can generate a project? We need to jump in creating project and just simply write this command, Vue create and hello world. And as I already mentioned, it's super important that you have interactive prompts in the console. So I will simply write here Vue, then create, and then the name. And actually, as this video is the part of Vue for Beginners series, I will name it Vue for Beginners. And now we're just hitting enter, and after this, as you can see, Vue CLI asks us some questions. So you need to have this interactive prompt. And here, first of all, we need to pick a preset. So we can install the default Vue 2 or Vue 3 preview or manually select features. What we want to do is manually select features, because then we can configure everything that we need. First of all, as you can see, we can hit space to select, toggle all we don't need, and invert we also don't need. So we just need space and enter. So if you want to check something, this is space, enter, you just apply all that you checked here. So first of all, we want to choose view version, this is fine. We need Babel to transpile everything, yes. We don't need TypeScript, no PWA. We need router, so we're hitting here space. Then we need Vuex, we're hitting here also space. And then we don't want CSS preprocessors, but we need linter. So this is all fine, and we just hit enter. Then we have a question, what version of view do we need? We have version 2 or version 3 preview. And actually version 3 of view was released not that long ago, and most of the packages are already stable. This is why we can simply take version 3, because this is newer, and after several months you will have only version 3. So I'm hitting here version 3 preview, and now do we need history mode for router? And we don't need it, because we have only frontend, so we don't have fallback for production on some backend server. And here we need to check what linter and formatting do we want. We want standard ESLint with error prevention. And now lint of on save is completely fine, and we want to place our configs in dedicated files. So we're just hitting enter, and we don't want to save this preset for future projects. So we're hitting no, and now we need to wait some time until it will install all dependencies. Now, as you can see, my project was successfully generated. Here we have a success saved log file and successfully created project view for beginners, and now we just need to jump inside this project and run yarn serve, and this will start our application on 8080 port. So we can actually open it already in localhost 8080, and now as you can see, we are getting this page that was generated with Vue CLI. So as you can see, we don't have any errors and everything is compiled successfully. Now, let's make this project a little bit cleaner, because we don't need all this stuff that was generated. So here I have the folder, which is opened with all files. We will talk about file structure later. For now, we just want to jump in source, and here we have app view. And this is our main component, where all this stuff is rendered. As you can see, we have here a lot of information, and we really want to just remove everything from the template here on the top. So I will remove links, I will just remove actually everything, and write here h1, and inside will be view for beginners. And the block with styles on the bottom we can simply delete completely. As you can see, we have now only 3 lines, and in the browser you can see that our page was automatically reloaded, and we are getting our message view for beginners. In this video, you learned the most correct part to create Vue.js applications. Actually, you just need to use Vue CLI tool and not just create plain index.html and put source there, because it's not scalable, and here out of the box you are getting the whole project, which is empty, with web server and page reloading. And if Vue for beginners is too easy for you, I have a full advanced course on Vue, which is going 10 hours, where we're creating the full real project from empty folder to the finished project. And I will link the link to this project and to all my other courses in the description box below. And if you like this video and you want more content like this, don't forget to put thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And I will see you in my next video.